asunjue enkamu hejole ahanye noti fafanam pba mumaye nyina sese ehu na ye mfi ye nsum ya se ewo nyame agya oba ene hun kronkron din mu amen. Yes, on China met Nada, Dan, I met some uncuto. I did be a rare in Pammy. My father compano so. One a main quamo and compano. Make cremo and unyam. Send ya bobe money banqua. Sir, oh ya mammy, sonny. Hina, no ya me ye. Sing woo out, domi da. Domni, papi bray, wawomu. Ma mi a me de hia hina na oye mi hina na o ma mi re chichi sin wo mira a wo de sro ni asase so to mi nyina ahye won sa amen ye be jina ho ara eyi nyame aye ato ye impress with nyoma eto so duba ko Radiasi wana doe ni hwese ni bombo aye kese ewo yenso afia twa mu sesebre no na ye nyina ye hyeden mu na ye ntumimpo emma sorry ene dey na da roma ye da so tin kwa mu a ewo se ye tumi danasi nya ha woda no nchoshi. I feel no who never been a war of fair war to me. None a drum on now. What can he wear a wall on me? Now, what da no chalice? Near Titi and he and young coupon term a young bonnie. Now, since I have Pamuka and bonnie trainer and a cough for any train, any say, are the young son number free young on Kaibium? Sam Ray Pamona can't. Upon it, Rade. It was more so name, Nancy or see Catrano. So Pimo can, but the best few. And then the year faith for what is ready, dear boy, Radia name. Oh, free fear, Elbano. On himself, over the share, Rade. And this I'm ready for what is ready, dear Elbano name. I'm going to call Nibby more, none call Chino. I'll phone young one here. ABNA, the Kakawal and Oko. The Radify, I don't want to say, I showed you no yum. So one man a day is so abetuyen. Moja elfru, your most sunny. Young Tekraman so a diabojim. What dumb young Afra church any venture yet? Eddie Abawa Nimha. A radiant pipe on his set. Oh, you were ni and free and Na mo over my yate won ka over my yen ho. Wo yen somu yi mo. Erade bra. Erade bra. Oni yen be fi ase. Na oni yen wie. Onya mi a oye ja oba. Ene won kron kron de mo da. Amen.
Yen kan kan sam a wapa. Ama ye na de yi no. Ye be hu wo Yohane. Tudumien. Nchichem. Edionu kwapem ediasa ediasa omayentie erade asem na hilafu bi wo won a wo bai se wo be sori afahye no asenum e na eyinum ba Filipo a ofi beseda a ewo Galilea no nchen na wo be sra no se owura ye pese ye hu Yesu. Filippo bai be kachre Andrea. Na afe Andrea ne Filippo be kachre Yesu. Na Yesu bua won se. Donu edu se. Wabe she onipaba no enyunyam. Nokare nokare, mise mu se. Enwifwa antofam enwu a. Ewa hokro no ara. Na se ewu a. Eso abapi nia odo ne kra no ebefi ne nsa na nia otan ne kra wa wi ha wi ase ha yi no oba kra no akoda nkwa mu so obi so me a ma oni mechi na nia me wa no eho na me som fo nso beba na so obi so me a meja bedi ni ni afe me kra ho yira uno na eden na menka eja jimi fidon yimu na nso eyinti na me ba don yimu eja shawudin enyonyam e na eni bi fisro bai se ma hye no enyonyam dedaw na me hye no bio e na nkrofo ku a wogina ho na wate no kai se apra na abom ebinum se abafo no kasai Yesu bua kan se enye mi nti na eni bai na mu nti afe ni wi ase atemu afe na wobe yi wi ase sodifo no ho na mede so what mame sufi asase so a matwini panyi na maba menchen eyi de oka de kire onko a obewu erade asemini
ibesiese yakuma dia tie erade asem every national clan director ho na enyoma ye de ibesiese yakuma no eh Presbyterian nyoma eto so aha nine edue number kon
Yeah. So Father, I want to give you all praise and honor for how far you have brought us all. Almighty God, this morning we are counting our blessings, naming them one after the other because of your favor upon our lives. We are spared not because of anything, not because of the good things that we do, but it is just by your grace that we are survivors of these challenging times. So we join our hearts together as your children, giving you all praise and adoration for your goodness, for your mercy, and especially for sparing our lives. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we bless your name for this fraternity, for this family. We thank you so much, oh God, for the celebration that we have all gathered today to magnify your name. 20 years of your goodness for the Presbyterian Brigade Association. May your name be glorified. Amen. Father, I pray that, oh God, you use me as a vessel to bless your hearers this morning. Almighty God, humbly I ask, it is not about me, but it is about the times that we find ourselves. Lord, it is not about me, but it is about the salvation of your people. Heavenly Father, it is not about me, but for your name to be glorified in our lives. Have your own way, Holy Spirit. Take control in the name of Jesus. Break down every heart here gathered. Give us listening ears, O God, and give us hearts to receive this good news. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Christ of God, have we prayed. Amen. Amen. PBA. Brethren, on behalf of the principal officers, the moderator of the General Assembly, the Right Reverend Professor Joseph Obri Abuamante, the Clerk of General Assembly, Reverend Dr. Godwin Inoue Odonko, I want to bring their special felicitation to this gathering. Today is a special day, a day set apart for us to celebrate the goodness of God in this special ministry, the ministry to the young people, the ministry of the Boys and Girls Brigade of the Presbyterian Church of Ghana. 20 years that the Presbyterian Church of Ghana had the idea to come together as a fraternity. I believe that God has done so many things. And as I stand here, I was one of the key people who started in the Western Presbytery about 20 years ago. And so we all together say, to God be the glory, great things he has done and greater things he will continue to do in the lives of the brigade. Hallelujah. The theme chosen for us this morning is Die with Jesus and Live. Die with Jesus and Live. Wuni Yesu inwu nenyankwa. Hallelujah. Brethren in the Lord, this is a special message or a special thing that is being given unto us this morning. And the scripture just read for us was taken from John's Gospel, chapter 12, verse 20 to 33. My dear brethren in the Lord, the background to this account is that Jesus was in a very difficult situation. Jesus knew what was going to happen to him the next moment, and what he would need to endure for the sake of the redemption of humanity. Jesus came to this world for a purpose, and that purpose must be achieved. Nothing should stop him from accomplishing that purpose for humanity, because we were helpless. We were unsaved. There was nothing good in us. We were condemned to die. And he was the only solution for our redemption. Praise the Lord. Jesus needed to die in order for the world to live. In the context of the message, some Greeks who had gone to the Jewish festival called the Feast of the Passover, according to John's Gospel, chapter 12, verse 1, had come to Philip asking to see Jesus. Yesi hela phobia. Na wako etwem afahye no. Na wako ye no. You wako akosum wotwam afahye ne de. Nanso wo hu hiahia se. Ese se wo hwehwe Yesu echi kwan. Hallelujah. Ese se wo hwehwe Yesu echi kwan. Asem a mi bi se wa no pay se. So many wo aha ye wo no. Are we looking for this Jesus? Many people find themselves on the pews on every Sunday. Their expectation is different. We have different expectations as we have met this morning. Nipa bebre ni da kwan se mere corporatera safu mu esa se mi wa menyo osofu ma wesie me na wode ma ba sori demu na ya bodon agumi so se meku na mekode a ene na nya asam ketua ye bodon ye ni obiriba se ne ebeya owua obenye ni pa di na chi o ya ifuro benya sori demu aye obi nsu di ya yonkofa. But I pray to God that our gathering every Sunday here will be to seek for Jesus. Hallelujah. I pray to God that your presence here would ya hu pepre ebe hwehwe wo nkwaje na would ya ye wo nkwaje ho adwuma. Don't let anyone stop you. Hallelujah. Don't let anything distract you. These men from a foreign land came searching for Jesus Christ, because they knew that anytime you come into contact with Jesus, something new will happen. They knew that when you encounter Jesus, your life will never remain the same. They knew that when you encounter Jesus, your problems will diminish. They knew that there is something good in Jesus. I pray that we will all be here in expectancy of one thing. My salvation, your salvation. So that one day, when this body is broken down, we'll be given a different body. And we'll celebrate Jesus together, dining with him in a special way. I pray that even as we have gathered here, the Lord would redirect our focus to salvation. Hallelujah. And so this man went to Philip, and Philip also took him to Andrew, and together they went to Jesus. Maybe they thought that occasion would be one of the times where Jesus is going to tell them something good. Today's church is sick because all that we are looking for is for us to get all the miracles in this world. We are chasing after perishable things. We are chasing after things that will be there tomorrow and the next day it is no more. But I'm here to announce to you, if you will desire the voice of God, that seasoned voice of God on daily basis, he will speak his word concerning your life. Hallelujah. The Bible says Jesus turned to them and made a proclamation, one that is not only for his disciples, but also for the young men or the Greek followers. This led to Jesus introducing a divine paradox, according to John's Gospel, chapter 12, verse 24. The Bible says, most certainly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains by itself alone. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Hallelujah. This sentence or statement was primarily meant to teach the wandering Greeks the true nature of the Messiah's kingdom, the kingdom he has come to establish. Maybe the Greeks thought they were coming to seek a king with a crown on his head. Maybe they thought they were coming to see a handsome man, well-dressed, and seated for other people to serve him. But they were pointed to the fact that he came to carry a cross and to die a shameful and dishonored death. Hallelujah. The kingdom he has come to set up begins with a crucifixion and not with a coronation. So that the purpose for coming to seek and save the lost will be materialized. Hallelujah. In fact, Jesus' death and resurrection was to spring up a mighty harvest of benefit to all mankind. My dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, his death like a grain of seed was to be the root of blessings and mercies to countless millions and millions of immortal souls. Jesus continues with a stronger paradox, and it goes like this. He who loves his life will lose it, and he who hates his life in this world will keep it to eternal life. That is the verse 25 of John's Gospel chapter 12. This is a practical application to the theme for the day. Die with Jesus and live. My dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, anyone who wants to be saved must be ready to give up life itself, if necessary, in order to obtain salvation. You must bury your love of this world with its riches, with its honor, with its pleasures and rewards, with a full belief that in so doing, you will reap a better harvest both here and thereafter. Hallelujah. According to Colossians chapter 2, verse 20, it attests to the fact that since we died with Christ to the elementary spiritual forces of this world, why, as though you still belong to the world, do you submit to its rules? According to Romans 6, verse 8, the Bible says, now if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. This truth must sink into our hearts this day, that there can be no crown without a cross. There can be no glorification without going through the suffering. The Christian journey is not easy. It's not easy for you to see a glass full of club beer with all the sweat around, the bubbles on it and the sweat around the glass. It is not easy for you to stand and say that, yes, I am a new creation, and so I am not going to touch this. It is not easy for you to see a woman with all the figures, the body structure and all the protrudings and whatever, and to say that I am a new creature and so I am not going to do this. It is not easy. It's a battle. The truth must sink in our hearts that without Christ's death, there would have been no life for the world. And for us to benefit from Jesus' death, we must be willing to die to sin and crucify that all that is most dear to our flesh. Apostle Paul testifies in Galatians chapter 2, verse 20, that I am crucified with Christ, and it is no longer I who lives, but it is Christ who lives in me. Our death in Christ is a death to the old self and our old ways and our sinful life. Apart from dying to the old ways and the old self, Jesus is expecting us. And so I ask this question, how can I die with Christ? Dying with Christ must be a daily activity. Especially during Easter time, you see a lot of people coming to church. My dear brothers and sisters, believers must know that dying with Christ must be a daily activity in our lives and not an annual thing, as we always see. Sorry, I pray to God that will not be our portion. We must work on daily basis. My dear brothers and sisters, how can we do that? Number one, you must acknowledge your new identity. If you don't acknowledge your new identity, it will be very difficult for you to die to the things of the flesh. As I say, who ni pakwa we ye? We are Christo ni ni edikan. We are basri ni ni atoswabie. We are ni pebi ayedi mojebi atowa bode. And so work as a royal. Say ye di moja ne toye nga bode dia. And yes, I say ye ye ho basa basa. As I say ye ye ho to say ni pebi ya. What di mojebi nebu ye den atoye. Na ye siye siye ye ho. Atre ye ura. Know your new identity. Acknowledge your new identity, that you are dead to sin and alive to righteousness. And when you acknowledge this, enuna asembiara ubekano adibiara meyano maybe sera de se ayenefe se ayenefe dia enye menang into me enduho. Jesus so completely represented us on the cross, and he died for us. We must acknowledge that fact. And we must do all that we can. As Paul said in Colossians chapter 3, verse 5. Therefore, consider the members of your earthly body as dead to immorality, dead to impurity, dead to passion, dead to evil desire, and dead to greed. And Paul concludes that all this, or all these, amount to idolatry. The second thing that we must take note for us to be able to die on a daily basis with Jesus is that we must practice the word. We must not just be hearers of his word. When we are walking, people must see us as walking Bible. Don't hate, love as much as you can. Brethren in the Lord, do we practice the word? The reality of the crucifixion of Jesus is that he did this for us so that we can also live in righteousness. There are people who know the word of God, but they don't know Jesus. They have not yet encountered Jesus. I pray that you will not be one of those people. May God help us so that in times like this, we can die to our old self. And if we can do this, we must practice the word. The third point is that we must have the right mindset. We must have the right mindset. Through thankfulness, in realizing that we were guilty and have been forgiven by Jesus because of his love, the spirit within you will enable you to live for him. Your mind is an important battleground when it comes to the war of sanctification. And so Proverbs chapter 23 verse 7 says, as a man thinks, so he is. My dear brothers and sisters, acknowledge the fact that as a Christian, you are dead to sin because of your relationship with Christ Jesus. When you arm yourself with all that I've mentioned as your mindset, it will begin to affect the way you live. Eventually, it will bring you to a place where you are no longer controlled by your sinful nature. The fourth way of dying with Christ is for you to offer yourself as a living sacrifice. Offer yourself as a living sacrifice. Turn from the deeds of the flesh and seek Jesus. Offer your body as a living sacrifice to Jesus, holy and acceptable, for that is our reasonable service. Romans chapter 12, verse 1. The fifth point that I'm raising is that make a conscious effort to follow Jesus. Ma wenim bro, ne di yesu echi, men di sophobia echi. Sofrano will also go and meet the judgment. Don't follow. Today we follow pastors, the images of pastors, than even following Jesus Christ. I have come to you to give you a special prescription that as you are seated here, please follow Jesus, serve him, and serve him well. Make every effort to know Jesus. Any Any church that you go to and the pointer is on the minister, please, there is no salvation there. But when you enter a church and the pointer is on the finished work of Christ Jesus, sit down, relax, and work on your salvation. Praise the Lord. Many of us are seated on the pews this morning, distracted by the desires of the flesh and by the pleasures of life, so much that we have become too busy to fellowship with the Father. We must disown the rules of our self-centeredness. Lay aside the striving for the pleasures of this world and serve God lovingly and freely. The theme has made us aware that when we die with Christ, we will live. The Bible says, he who loves his life will lose it. And he who hates his life in this world will keep it to eternal life. John chapter 12, verse 25. Again, we must understand that John 12, 26b also says, where I am, there will my servant also be. If this new kingdom is what Jesus came to accomplish, then where Jesus is, baby, are you not desiring for that place to be with Jesus forever? For me, I'm so desirous. And I wish you will also be desirous. Praise the Lord. And John's Gospel chapter 26, he also says, if anyone serves me, the Father will honor him. When we die with Christ, we'll be justified. Justified for our glorification, according to 1 Corinthians 15, 5. We will enjoy consistent fellowship, communion with God. When we die with Christ, we will enjoy eternal life. Hebrews chapter 8, verse 8 to 9. My dear brothers and sisters, as I bring my message to an end, I want to reiterate that through Christ, we can become a new creation. And when we become a new creation, we'll have a new name and we'll receive eternal life. And because of that identity, we no longer walk in darkness, but in his marvelous light. I'm asking you, have you died with Christ yet? Have you died to your old self? Or you are still waiting on a false death? My dear, decide to die with Jesus today. My fathers, my mothers, my sisters, my brothers, decide to die with Jesus today. And I pray that you live by faith and through the guidance of the Holy Spirit. I pray that you'll be able to walk and practice the word of God on a daily basis. Don't just show up in church, but make a conscious effort to see Jesus. Say, tell the person sitting by you, I'm here searching for Jesus. May God bless you. Amen.
Brigade, a international organization. Ever Ghana, actually, ye pa. And now I am sorry I will be there, came boom, and ye brigade, that's what it's, sir, pepe penne. Now, so no, as a phobia, per se, a boob one, a man, no. Now, what ye brigade, no, send me a saffonish, say, and a now panty. It's a bribe de can, a boob or marrow the dow. Yeah, so in Sidu, about 20 years now, that we have also brought our boys and girls in brigade together. We still have a national brigade, but denominations bring their boys and girls together under the umbrella of that particular denomination. For the Presbyterian Church of Ghana, we see the Brigade as a powerful tool for Christian nurturing. And that land. It is also an unassuming tool for evangelism and church planting under the Department of Mission and Evangelism. Brigade, Presbyterian of Ghana, is a reliable tool for the expression of ecumenism, bringing other churches together. And this comes under the Department of Ecumenical and Social Relations. Again, our brigade is a notable tool for fundraising, and they operate, therefore, under the Department of Finance. Brigade is a dependable tool for communal labor and social development, and this comes under the Department of Social Services. It is a supplementary tool for the enhancement of formal education. Apart from Christian nurturing, ni ayesia wo school munso no wo buapa ba de chere adesua ekoso. The brigade has administrative structures worthy of emulation. That is under the Department of Administration. And so if we look at the brigade and look at it very well, carefully, it spans across the entire Presbyterian Church of Ghana. As we celebrate our 20th year, the launching being done here, beyond this place, and beyond this day, there are several activities to be celebrated in various courts of the church. And then, finally, the actual celebration of the 20th anniversary will take place in the Western Presbytery. And so today, on behalf of my dear sister, clan director, and therefore behalf of the entire Church, the President of Ghana, giving cognizance to the principal officers, I launch the 20th anniversary of Presbyterian Brigade Association in the name of God, who alone is Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mama yambo banana sumpai eja kronkron a wo ye oshren yam pa boni se wo ba so kania na shren e wo bana yisu ba bi biera wo de besen abodawru dawru kase dia ma jumeri kase a bigade ridi ganda ha nyina adenti yese bebre Wodum Edno so Ewa Bana Yisu Enye Juma Efanche Udinu Nyam Yeshra Bana Yisu Ejaba Edo Kronkudimu. Amen. Awurade ho nhyira. Medofo ene ensempa watse no. Enkyerɛ wo ɛwɔ wo koma pon so. Wanante Onyankopɔn asɛmpa yi mu. Watumi apa wo ho akyi. Na Awurade de hene wasetere mu. Na wɔtwe yi, Yehowa nti dɔ no mekyerɛ wo, ɔnyɛ w'adom soro wo nko. Ɔnhwɛ wo so wode fi ɛde wo fie bɛnyi nnara mu. Na yɛ akwanhyia nyinaa wɔde mpa ne nyinaa gu mfa mma wo. Na yɛ adesua a ɛbu kɔn mu Awurade ɛnsua wo. Na yɛ esum Awurade mfa ne kanea ɛmpa mu fi w'asetena na w'abrabɔ nyinaa mu. Brigade, Awurade nhyira mo. Afe yi fa a mohyɛ no ɛnkɔ so yiye. Afe yɛn nyinaa san ka Awurade Yesu so dom. Nyankopɔn dɔ ɛne Honhom Kronkron ayɛ nkofa fi saa bere yi kɔsi daa nyinaa. Momfa asomdwoeɛ nkɔ. Amen.